Welcome back to Albany County Fasteners, Fasteners 101. I'm Bob, and today we're going to talk about gulling. But before we do that, please subscribe, share my videos, and hit the bell so we can notify you when we have a new video up. Also, leave me some comments. If you have questions, we want to respond to you and help you out. Congratulations to the winners of the beanies. We've reached out to you for the information. Get back to us, the ones that haven't, so we can get you your beanies right away. So today we're going to demonstrate to you gulling, how to prevent gulling, the scenario where certain fasteners do not gull, and it's all about those nuts. So let's get into it, the nuts and bolts, and let's get started. So I have here a hex cap screw and a finished nut. Hex cap screws in general are rolled threads, and nuts are cut threads. And when you cut threads, the difference is that you get more fiber on the threads, metal fibers. So I'm going to take this and I'm going to put it in my vise, the hex cap screw, and I'm going to take the nut, which is a standard heavy hex nut, and this nut will show no signs of gulling because there's no resistance. Basically, I have four of them here. I'm just going to screw those on, and you'll find that I don't even need any anti-seize or anything like that. This is nut after nut. A non-issue. No gulling. Can be a little rough in certain areas because of the fiber, the metal fibers in there. But basically, a regular finished nut or a heavy hex nut or a jam nut that have no nylon inserts in them, you should have no issues with those. Now, if you are having issues, then possibly you have the wrong threads between the both items. So what I'm saying is that if this was a quarter 20 and this was a quarter 28, you're going to start cross threading. It's one's fine thread and one is coarse thread. So if you're putting a regular nut on a screw or a bolt and it's starting to go up, there's a reason for that. You shouldn't have an issue with these. Now, nylon insert lock nuts. These are jam nuts. So I have some jam nuts here. I have a nylon lock nut standard here. And I have a waxed nylon insert lock nut. And I showed you the heavy hex nut. So I'm going to demonstrate for you putting these nylons on, which will create friction, and they will create a buildup of the metal fibers against the backside of this nylon, which will create gulling. And that's where the problem happens. And there are many reasons for this. So let me demonstrate to you. So I have some anti-seize here. The problem with anti-seize, it can get a little messy depending on your project. As you can see there, it's like a paste. And the anti-seize works just great. So if you're just buying regular nylons with no wax on them and you want to use anti-seize, I recommend you do that. However, if you're buying wax, you shouldn't need any anti-seize. So I have some anti-seize here. I'm just gonna put a dab of it on. Not much is required, just a dab. Just like that. You should wear gloves when putting this on. You put too much on, it's gonna get messy. So avoid that. That's nice and smooth. That's the right way to put it on. Okay, the anti-seize worked perfectly. No resistance. So it's just a very little amount of anti-seize. And if you want to, you can get a little cup and you can put some anti-seize in, just dip the tip of the bolt a little bit in it. That would save some time. And you can see there, what you will see is that it does make the threads dirty. So if you're doing a car project or something like that, you know, it's not gonna shine. You know, it's not gonna have that really clean look unless you get in there with some cleaner and remove it after you put the nut on. So let's go into a standard nylon lock nut. You'll see that I can start to turn this on until it gets to the point of the nylon. Then it starts to tighten up because now we're threading the nylon. At the same time, what's happening there, any fibers that are cut, okay, remember I said before that the screw and the hex bolt are rolled threads? These are cut threads, they're cut with a lathe. So what happens is that there are more fibers in the nut than you're gonna have on the actual bolt. And I'm going to put this ratchet on and then I'm gonna start to turn, okay? And in this situation, I'm not getting any resistance. Oh, I just started to. Okay, that's because it's hitting the device. So I'm going to, you can see I turned that on all the way with no going. So I'm not having an issue in this situation. And then I'm gonna back it off. So many of you also ask, can I take off a nylon lock nut and put it back on? Well, as you see here, you will see that I'm going to take it off. So I'm removing that nylon with no problem. Now, we may not gull any of this stuff up. It's all possible. It all depends on the manufacturing. If there's more metal fibers in the nut, the more issues you're going to have. Now you can see, and it's pretty hard to see this, you can see that nylon is threaded. Because when it's first manufactured, it's just a piece of plain nylon. Now it's threaded. So I can put this back on, and it'll still perform the same way. You see it's tight again. And now I'll put this on. And it's vibration resistant, because that's what they're for, nylons. So yes, you can remove a nylon lock nut and reinstall it. How many times? Obviously, the more you do it, it's gonna get looser over time. So I'm gonna remove this one. Let's take another nut. And I will tell you that I feel a little more resistance right now that I've reused this nylon. I'm going to take the drill because some of you asked about drills. This is an impact unit and the impact doesn't work until it actually starts to lock up. But you know, I don't know how far I'm going to be able to get here. But you can use them. I would not recommend high speed, very low speed. The faster you go, the more the nylon heats up. And as it creates friction, that's how you get more gulling. So you want to kind of prevent that. So I don't have the proper socket here, deep enough. I have to add that to my tool chest. But as you can see here, I'm not having any issue with going. So I'm just going to take another nut, another screw, hex cap screw, and let's try it again. I'm going to take another nylon. This is a standard. I'm going fast. Because typically what happens is you go faster, the more resistance you'll get. Oh, it just gulled up. Okay, so you'll see there. Okay, we're going. It's starting to go up. So what's happening is, as I go faster, it starts creating more heat, more friction. There's more changes in the metals and the nylon. So the gulling starts to happen. So if you were to use an impact tool or a battery powered drill and you put a driver into it, chances of gulling become even more, a higher percentage. Your chances are a lot higher. So I can feel some spots here where this is going up, but it's not totally 100% seized. So you can feel resistance as you go, but it hasn't seized all the way. Let's do another one. Okay, so we got going. Here we go. We finally got one. Look what happened. I just snapped it. That is what we call seizing a gulling nut and bolt that seized up, and I snapped it. That's the result I want to show you. And you can see that the faster you go, the more friction you create. It doesn't mean every single one it's going to happen. It could be one out of a dozen. And here is the perfect scenario of what happens. And I always get these emails or questions, why has this happened to me? There's really, this is really a problem of the materials. It's just inherited with stainless steel. So you'll see this time and time again. And I'll take another one now. And I'm gonna use the waxed nylon lock nuts. Okay, these are waxed. They're put into a batch of hot wax. They're spun dry, and there's a nice coat of wax on these, and they can still gull up, but your percentage of it happening are very small. This is nice and smooth. I tell you, amazing difference. And there you go. It just goes on, very clean and nice. So if you have projects that you don't want to deal with the gulling, and you don't want to deal with the mess of anti-seize, then get the waxed nuts. Perfect. So let's recap. When putting a nylon lock nut on, you want to give steady pressure. Use a hand ratchet or a screwdriver type socket if you can. When using an impact or a battery drill to apply your nuts, which I would not recommend, steady, slow speed. The higher the speed, the more friction you create, the more heat you create, chances of gulling percentages increase. So I would avoid the impact or the battery drill or hand drill, but you can use them, but at slow speeds and steady. Don't jerk the trigger, which a lot of people like to do. Try not to jerk the wrench as you're putting on or off the nut. And also what you learned is that screws and bolts are rolled formed, whereas nuts, they're cut. Thanks for watching.